Hello guys, this is a test vlog. Let's see how the video comes out. I'm heading to meet my friend at Banarghatta Road. It's another 10 kilometers from here, hopefully. In this video, you can see many squid as well, people on the road walking around like zombies. That's a new petrol pump. I have recently reached to Kodaikanal. I recorded a vlog, but okay, I'm getting a call. That was Siddharth from my group. Yes, 2 years back I started a group called HRC. HRC means Hillsong Riders Club, but now we changed it to Highway Riders Club since we did not want to promote the name Hillsong. You can see Bangalore traffic. Barely anyone follows the rules in Bangalore, or I must say India. This is my scooter, which I use for daily commuting, because this is the best way to commute in Bangalore. You can avoid a lot of traffic on scooters. Looks like there is no much traffic. Hopefully I'll reach there soon. My friends are already there halfway. I really need to fix the mic, you know, so that you can hear me clearly. I really don't know how good you can hear me now. Well, this is my second time motor vlogging, and I'm really enjoying it since I'm alone on my bike, or should I say scooter. You can observe that no one really follows lane discipline in Bangalore, whereas in Bombay, lane discipline is followed. That's the new Tata Hexa. Really beautiful car. That's the green signal. You can see the roads are not that great. No footpaths. And even though there are footpaths, supplied by fruit vendors and small vendors, they are not supposed to put their stalls there, but they bribe the police every day, a part of their earnings, and you can work it out here. See, you can see one more example, selling blankets. Let's say, YouTube name is Macho Biker. He has the Hillsong GT250R. We are on a city road since, that's why we don't have gear. a soft project, custom projector actually. It cost him around 14,000 just to install that white light, HID light. With all the custom clamps. The projector lens actually belongs to a Mercedes-Benz J-Class. I'm on a scooter and he's on a bike. That's why he's fast. Maybe he'll stop and wave back when it exits the night road. India has too many scooters and bikes for commuting, just like in China. Wow, that exhaust note is good. The replica exhaust. Available in Jetty Road. I think he will be taking the night road from here. But that will be closer and traffic free for him directly to his home. One of the most careful bikers I have met. Bye bro! My other friends were in a car, so maybe in the upcoming vlog I'll introduce you. That's a Royal Enfield with a stock exhaust, maybe a 350 or a 500. You can't really tell the difference because both look the same. I'm actually waiting for the new 650 Royal Enfield, a 600, whatever. Too many bottles on the road. All the cars are standing bumper to bumper, and if I had come in a car, it could take me another hour to reach my home. This is Bannerghatta Road. It's a single lane state highway. That's a BMW X1, previous generation. I really like the new generation, you know, much beautiful. Tried to overtake him but I couldn't due to the oncoming traffic. Let's go slow, there's no hurry. The speed limits in the city are 40 kmph. If you have a super bike, you can't keep up at 40 kmph in the city. You will have to drive fast and you will end up getting fined sometimes, since they don't have 24-hour camera system installed in Bangalore. I don't want to take risk. This is actually a test vlog. I won't be doing much city vlog, but if you like, you can comment down below. If you want city vlog and overview on the squids and zombies walking around on this road, I would really like to settle in abroad, places like US or in Dubai, just because of the road safety and the rules all of them follow, and good roads and facilities, like a proper footpath for people to walk on. Even though Dubai has a lot of sand situated in the desert areas, it's one of the cleanest places I've seen in my life. I've been to Dubai twice though. Even though there's a lot of rush during peak hour, it's much organized. And it's only, it comes in under one of the safest cities, which is 0% crime. There are many videos on this also on YouTube. You can check them out. By the way, I forgot to mention, I own a Hyosen GT650R. I know it's a beginner bike for all of you international people watching my videos, but it's one hell of a bike in India. It cost me around 5,65,000 when I purchased it. And you can see there is so much traffic, bumper to bumper, for around 2 to 3 kilometers, maybe. Let's see if we can cut through traffic since I'm on a scooter. I've been mumbling a lot because I'm just getting used to what to tell and what not to tell and how to tell and all that. Hopefully you all can understand. As I go on with my channel, as I progress, I'll be making better videos, better editing. For now, I have very minimal skills and minimal editing app and minimal software. Many things are there which make you a very good blogger, photo blogger. I am inspired by my friends to do YouTube. I'm here to share the memories I make on bikes and scooters with my family, my friends, and everyone in the world. In India, bikers have a bad name. My goal is to make that a good name. Bangalore has become too crowded nowadays. I read an article saying Bangalore will be unlivable within 5 years just by the crowd coming in from everywhere, since this is the hub for electronic companies, the software companies. Bangalore is also known as Silicon Valley or Silicon City. Before, it was known as the Green City, which is very minimal nowadays. The greenery is cut down a lot. I think I'll sign off here. I'll see you in the next vlog.